Python's standard library is loaded with modules you might not be aware of. One of the more out-of-the-way modules is DBM, a way to persist key value pairs to disk for a program. It's for when you need only enough functionality to automatically stash a few pieces of data and nothing else, so it's handy for quick and dirty use cases. And as of Python 3.13, it's been upgraded to work with SQLite for greater convenience. So let's take a look at DBM in action and see how it can also use SQLite today. The idea behind DBM is that you can persist key value pairs, as with a dictionary, to a file automatically. The main limitation is that keys and values both have to be strings. They can't be any other Python data type. In this simple example, I'm using DBM to create an object named DB, which is backed on disk with a file named mydata.db. When we set key value pairs in DB, like this, they are written out to disk automatically, as long as we do any key writing operations inside this context block. We can retrieve the values from the DB in much the same way that we would retrieve values from a dictionary. And again, we would want to do those operations inside this context block so that we're dealing with live data. Everything outside the context block, the file is closed. We can also manually open, read, write, and close DBM objects like this, much as we would for a regular file object. But with any changes, we want to use the update method to ensure that anything that we've manipulated in the object is synchronized back out to disk. Now, this example uses the default backend on Windows for DBM, which is relatively slow since it's implemented in pure Python. It's also not a very robust or fault-tolerant data format. However, in Python 3.13, DBM got a little tweak. It can use the SQLite database, also included by default with Python, as its storage system. And this gives us a couple of advantages. First off, SQLite is a much more durable storage format than any of the other DBM backends. And two, it's easier to use the data we've stashed that way, since support for SQLite is pretty broad. We could use it in other programs if we needed to. But the durability and the overall speed of SQLite, those are big selling points by themselves. So I'm going to erase the old database, and I'm going to rerun this program using Python 3.13. And when we do so, the new default database format is SQLite. You'll notice we now have a new, differently formatted database file in there. And we can open this database file using a third-party utility that I have for browsing SQLite databases, and we can inspect the data that's inside. Now, DBM doesn't try to do anything very sophisticated with SQLite as its backend. Keys and values are still only strings, and they're stored internally in SQLite as blob objects. But that's fine for basic key values, and again, there are many scenarios where you don't need more than that. It's often more convenient to use DBM and its dict-like interface to store these kinds of things than it would be to read in and write back out a JSON file, for instance. Now, what if you need more than just strings as values? And that's something I'm going to be exploring in the next video, which is about DBM's slightly more sophisticated cousin in the standard library, shelv. So if you like this video, leave a comment below. And don't forget to follow Dev with Serdar and InfoWorld on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.